बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इट इज ऑलवेज फैसिनेटिंग टू टॉक अबाउट स्नेक्स। देर इज लॉट ऑफ फियर एंड ऑरा अटैच्ड विद स्नेक्स। टुडे वील डिस्कस स्नेक्स एंड स्नेक बाइट्स। फर्स्ट few general remarks about the snakes. Well, there has been traditional enmity between man and snakes, and in most of the cases the man is aggressor and the snake bites in defense. Most of the snakes, they are not poisonous and they do not bite the man without provocation. Exception is king cobra. And it has been observed that women are less prone to snake bites than the men. The reason is that men go out and work in agricultural fields, etc., more commonly, and they challenge the snakes more commonly than the women. It has also been observed that peripheral parts of the body are involved more than the trunk and abdomen. Feet and hands, they are more commonly involved in snake bites. At times, instead of two, there is only one fang mark present on the body of the victim. This can occur when the person is moving or the bite is on the uneven surface of the body or the clothes they intervene. And it has also been observed that immediately after winter season, bites by the snakes are much more lethal. The reason is, in winter season, the snakes, they go into hibernation and venom goes on accumulating in their parotid glands. And when they come out after winter season, first few bites are very, very lethal. The victims of snake bites should not run towards the hospital. In fact, they should be taken to the hospital, because when in panic, the victim runs, the circulation becomes very rapid and absorption of venom is more rapid. So, activity immediately after snake bite is not recommended. Medically important snakes have fangs at the front of their mouths, and they inject poison secreted by their parotid glands. The zoologists have told us that there are 3,500 species of snakes, and they have divided poisonous snakes into various families. For example, elapid snakes. These are neurotoxic snakes. Example is king cobra. They have short, fixed fangs. Then there are sea snakes, which are myotoxic, found in coastal areas. Viper snakes are vasculotoxic. These vasculotoxic snakes have fangs like a syringe, long canalized needle, just like a syringe. The crotalin type are pit vipers. They have pits in between their two eyes. And viperine snakes are without pits. They don't have any pit in between the eyes. Then there are tree snakes, bird snakes, or flying snakes. These are found in continent of Africa. They, when bite, not very poisonous, just produce a bruise on the body. These are not poisonous snakes. This is a sea snake found in coastal area. In fact, this is king cobra snake. Next, these are viper snakes. This is sea snake found in coastal areas. This is flying snake, bird snake, or tree snake. Now, what are the factors which determine whether an incident of snake bite is going to be fatal or otherwise? Number one is age of the victim. If the affected person, the victim, is very old or a very young child and he is bitten by a poisonous snake, outcome usually is fatal. Then size of the snake. If the size of the snake is bigger, the snake contains more venom in his parotid gland. Site of bite also matters. If the bite is direct into the blood vessel, then outcome is fatal. Similarly, bites close to the trunk are usually fatal. Season, I already told you, bites are very lethal at the end of the winter when snakes come out of hibernation. Then next factor is presence of microorganism. What type of microorganisms are present in the oral cavity of the snake? For example, if Clostridium tetani is present, it will cause tetanus. If Clostridium welchii is present, it will cause gangrene. And finally, the activity of the victim after the bite, we have already discussed it. A person becomes panic, starts running in panic, his circulation becomes rapid and absorption of poison is, venom is also very rapid. Epidemiology. Mainly it's a rural and occupational hazard, affects men more than the women. More bites occur during the daytime when people are outside their houses, working in the agricultural fields, or walking in hilly areas, jungles. It has also been observed that peripheral parts, especially the feet, are more commonly involved in snake bites. It is said that about 50% of the cases escape with little or no poisoning. However, serious poisoning can occur, which can lead to death even in the rest of 50%. At early stage, especially in first 12 hours, snake bite is quite unpredictable. What is the outcome? Well, it is unpredictable. Nobody can predict it. Next. Pathophysiology of snake bite. Poisoning or envenoming. It involves multiple toxic reactions and many autopharmacological substances are released by activation of the kinin and complement systems. The snake venom consists of mixture of toxic enzymes and proteins, which include neurotoxins, cardiotoxins, hemolysins, phosphatase, hyaluronidase, cholinesterase, and an unknown enzyme which inhibits cytochrome oxidase. In early period after snake bite, that is early signs of systemic envenoming, these are of two types, non-specific and specific. Non-specific are vomiting, hypotension, that is decreased blood pressure, and polymorphonuclear leukocytosis. These are early non-specific signs of poisoning by a snake. This is snake venom. Specific or specific depend what type of snake has bitten the man. With vipers, there is abnormal bleeding from the gums, from the in the scrotum, and also from the fang marks, and also from various body orifices, from nose, from anal area, and other natural body orifices. With elapid bites like king cobra, there is ptosis and glossopharyngeal palsy. When sea snakes bite, as they are myotoxic, there is generalized myalgia and myoglobinuria. Now this chart shows this gives information whether a snake bite by a particular type of snake can be fatal, and what is fatal period, and what type of effects it will produce. In elapid bites, poisoning occurs in 50% of the cases. With sea snake bites, poisoning occurs in 80% of the cases. With viper bites, poisoning occurs in 30% of the cases. Local effects: with bites by elapid snakes, There is slow swelling, local necrosis, as occurs with bite by cobras. With sea snakes, there is no remarkable finding. Local finding is not very prominent. With viper bites, there is rapid swelling and necrosis locally at the site of bite. Systemic effects. With elapid snakes, there are neurotoxic and cardiac effects. With sea snake bites, there are myotoxic effects. There is myoglobinuria and hyperkalemia. With viper snakes bite, there are vasculotoxic effects and abnormal bleeding from body orifices and from fang marks. With elapid bites, death can occur from 5 to 12 hours time. With sea snakes bites, death can occur within 15 hours. And with viper bites, death can occur within 2 days time. How to manage a case of snake bite? First, how to provide first aid to a victim of snake bite? Well, when a person is bitten by a snake, he becomes panicky, he becomes psychologically disturbed, he becomes fearful. So you have to reassure him. You have to tell him that most of the snakes are not poisonous. For placebo effect, you can give injection tetanus toxide. Then you immobilize the bitten part. After that, apply a tourniquet just above the site of bite. If bite is on the elbow, you just take a rolled bandage or string and apply above that point so that venom does not circulate in the rest of the body. If rubber bulb is available, after giving an incision, you can suck blood through that. This is the time that you collect blood sample for blood grouping, because once the venom starts producing its effects, the results of blood grouping can be incorrect or misleading. So it is advisable to collect blood sample at this time. When the person reaches the hospital, how to manage such a case? If first aid has not been provided, provide the first aid as described above. Collect blood sample for blood grouping. Give test dose of antivenom. If the patient is not sensitive to that, give polyvalent antivenom intravenously in a drip. Prophylactically, you can give antibiotics. Steroids and adrenaline at times has to be given to counteract the allergic and hypersensitivity reaction of the venom, antivenom. Analgesics like injection morphine can be given, and anti-tetanus serum, ATS, should also be given after giving test dose. if disseminated intravascular clotting occurs, DIC, if it occurs, give heparin injection. You can also give IV fluid, and at times blood has to be transfused. Autopsy examination. If death of the person occurs, you have to do autopsy examination. On autopsy examination, look for the fang marks. If incision and suction has been done as a first aid measure, collect specimen from that area, from that site of bite, from the wound area, and send it for chemical analysis. Also collect specimen of blood and send it for chemical analysis. Other possible findings on autopsy examination are congestion due to asphyxia, edema of the brain and lungs. Blood in such cases, especially with viper bites, is extremely fluid. Hemorrhages from the punctures, that is fang marks, occurs, and also from various body orifices. That is why lot of fear is related with snake bites. Medico-legal significance. Snake bites mostly are accidental, but while performing autopsy, you have to rule out the foul play. Homicidal cases have also been reported, but very rare. Similarly, suicidal also very rare. It is said that Queen Cleopatra of Egypt committed suicide through snake bite. When enemy forces were about to enter her palace, she arranged snake in a basket of flowers and committed suicide through snake bite. In our rural areas, cattle poisoning is done by introducing rags impregnated with cobra venom into the rectum of the cattle of enemies. This is the medico-legal significance of snake bite. Well, here is a word of advice. If you have to travel in hilly areas, in jungles, where snakes are in abundance, make use of thick rubber gloves, long rubber shoes, and also keep a snake bite kit with you, which should contain a scalpel, a syringe, a string to be used as tourniquet, rubber bulb, injection morphine, antiseptic solution. So whenever you are traveling in such areas, be ready to face your traditional enemy, the snake. Well, we stop here. Thank you very much.